Faker and Zoe. Third POG of the split. Zoe was helping the top lane, Zoe was helping the Herald. Faker picked up 6 votes out of 9 for this POG.
Because he does have kind of a differing champion pool from some other AD carries, is the Nidalee is going to be the choice here.
Nidalee Renekton.
Zed?
No.
Zed or Bed?
No, he wouldn't. No, we can't get excited about this. We're not allowed to. Until it's locked in, we don't talk about hovers.
No,
he's just playing with us. No, it's going to be
Come
Zoe again.
On.
No, it's not happening. It's not happening.
Okay.
They let us wait till the last second.
Yeah.
And they don't give it to us. This, of course, does make a lot of sense. The 2v2 is kind of awkward, where you will be able, Ahsoka, to build. Because I do think that Faker actually has a lot less space than compared to the last game. Because last game, very nice. Game 1, 100% win or hit rate on spears.
GG? Yeah, she is it happening?
Oh,
it's happening.
Oh, boy.
No surprise here, guys. As the flash is all coming in. 2 from the side of T1. They're really trying to force this.
And just immediately punish him. As Kalz?
Ghost is going to come in here. He's trying to get him off the wall. And with no flash available, it's a little bit awkward for Kuzma. The flash over the wall now from Solka, who, oh man, he's going to get kited out here. No flash on the Syndra. The flash comes in now from Faker. The sleep coming in. The damage will be there. First blood to the Zoe, as Kana now is going to move forward and look to bite off a little bit more. But he's going to have to be satisfied with the 1 kill. Nar, you do set up potential kills in the future. As we're going to take another look here at this fight.
And it's the early presence of Syndra, one of the reasons why she is so popular, that has Faker very low. Kalz with a really nice sidestep here on this scatter, is then able to jump over the wall. This is still fine. I think Ahsoka, you're never allowed to go over it because you have a Hecarim who just has Ghost who can't actually follow you.
And no scatter.
Too far off. Yeah, you just use your scatter, right? And like, even then, there's a Renekton there, so you definitely die. And this is beautiful for Gunner as well. Like, go in with the slice and dice, use your empower Q to heal up, and then go.
Oh, you don't mind doing it. You beat the K right now. Chomchani,
he said, you know, if we can get this going early, I can carry in the future, basically.
Well, after last game, I can't fault him for that assessment. And true, these guys are like, instead of 17, they're like 20.
But still, compared to Faker,
well, yeah.
As we do have a tree down on the bottom side, Becca looks like he's just dead. Not sure how that one started, but still, it's a 2v2 kill, this time in favor of T1's bottom lane. So, again, as I mentioned, no flash for Kingen, no escape. And that's just what that's going to mean. And Faker finds Pioshik. I don't know if he can get any help from his team, but he's at least being annoying here.
Basically, a dead Yordle on your screen. And yeah, this is just straight up. I don't know why that guy is there. Bao has no mana and is looking to back. Just a miscommunication, presumably. And with no, look, the timeout comes in. Actually, I would have loved if Kingen moved into the Dominus range here, because that would have, like, procced the turret.
Now we're looking to turn the tides, potentially, onto Kana, who does not have his Dominus. That's going to be the Gnar into the wall. We got the Horsey on top of him, and there's no escape for him now. So
an empowerment to kill the Meek there at the end to maybe sustain up for a little bit longer.
Ooh, gonna miss on that one, but he lands the bubble. No flash available for Solka, and with the Everfrost, you might just go down. And yes, he does. As now the ultimate comes out here from the Hecarim, the flash a little bit optimistic. He's even gonna hold on to his ultimate there, so pretty fine. As Karia just taking a beating here from the cow, actually trying to turn this around. He's going in. Look at him, he's going 1v2, and he sets up the kill now for Faker. And that is the presence you need to be a superstar support player.
You're feeling very good.
Oh, not again. Well, he's just, even Kuz is getting in on this one. Faker's like, yeah, you can have it this time. I'm fine with that. And he still has the Rift Herald, guys.
Listen,
so
I think this is where the trumpets start playing. And like, oh, this is not the game you're looking for. As DRX, it was a very hard fought game number one.
Don't you remember that reference I made in
actually, you're
first
right.
Series?
You know, you've actually been improving. I really appreciate that.
Leroy,
you know?
Jenkins. Kuz is actually just looking to solo King in. Gets the flash available. That's a nice little exhaust that Faker was able to pick up. Ignite comes in and more sparkles. Is just barely able to get him. That was actually looking like a little bit of a 8 minutes into the game and
6,000
gold. 6K. Over 6,000 gold even. And Karia, you know, everybody on the side of T1 is smurfing, right? Karia has been so present. This is like one of those Soluku games where the enemy support is always in the mid lane and your support is never there. Of course, he's able to do that because of the way the bottom lane went as well. So you talked about all the lanes winning. You know, Karia's making the most of it.
He's the amount of Cloud Souls is,
yeah,
like it's found.
I don't think Kana really cares. I think he can 1v2 them. Like,
he doesn't care.
Even with the Ignite, you could see that DRX are just like, you know what? Like, we don't know 100%. And you can see he's even sniffing around here. He's like, someone left? Yeah. Not actually going to be able to hit Yoshi fair. We got a big push that's happening in the top lane, getting a nice amount of damage here. Still pretty early on in the game, guys. You're at 20 minutes.
With the Q spam, can get some damage done, but oh boy.
Oh, he's going to find him there. And we have the stun lock coming in. See you later. Spear from miles away for huge amounts of damage. Now Becca's going to have to ult here. And it's just chaos on the rift. Nobody can get away from T1. Becca not even able to get through the wall, and that's two free kills right before the Mountain Drake. And Karia is just laughing at you. I mean, this is T1 right now. They're scouring around the Baron here, trying to deny as much vision as possible.
DRX.
DRX, they're going back to some old school
strategies.
Nobody's in the brush. Nice job, Jonas Strong. No, not that one either. Oh, they're on your blue buff, of course. That's where they are.
And this, I love this. Like, this is yet again an example of like how smurf our observers are, because it's so easy to forget like how much the players don't see. Is he gonna face check? Is it gonna work? The bamboozle?
Do you think they have any idea? Oh, Faker checks it! And now, actually, Karia might die here. He's got the aftershock going, though. Will he survive through three people shelling onto him? Looks like the answer will be no, but it doesn't matter. He survives for long enough, and everybody else on the side of DRX will die. Teddy 1v1ing the Gnar here. The ultimate does come in, though, but the burst is not there. Faker's able to come in and help him out. And now it's almost a 10,000 gold lead at 24 minutes as T1 will casually take the Baron.
Clearly not in the mood for fun and games. Faker sniffing that one out. And as you said, yeah, collapsing on this Leona. I don't know about that one, Chief. As they throw everything into him, it doesn't actually do anything. Cuz is there. Faker is there. The teleports are immediately channeled. And as soon as it's not like a 5v2, as the DRX, you know, like, this is over. Right? We're so far behind. There's just no way that we're going to make this work. As I'm pretty sure Bao just blows
up. Oh, so this is why they didn't have a Kai'Sa. I see. Oh. Okay, good to know.
Yeah.
He does cleanse. React to that. Oh. Observer's at it again. Where is everybody? They're all here in the brush again. And trying to fight from 10,000 gold down, but it seems like there are enough members of T1 here to get the damage done. The Zenith Blade is going to miss, but it just doesn't matter. They're smurfing him. We got the triple kill for the Xayah. Can we set up the Penta?
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 Penta? No.
No, this isn't Ruler. No. They're all going to run away. DRX, not happy with the way this game is going to go. No free Pentas here. But it is the triple for the Xayah, and that's good enough.
They just keep doing this. I can't believe it.
Oh, trying to burst down Faker. He's got the W flash, and he is going to go down. So they do kill him. And the unofficial Penta comes in, the triple double. Over to Teddy on the Xayah. So there you go. We have a interesting end to the game. T1 with the Baron on 26 minutes. They're actually looking to push to end this one. We'll see if they can actually pull it off here as their wallets are so incredibly large right now. Stacking up the cash. In goes Kana. Finds Solka. See you later. Puts him in the ground. And that's going to do it, guys. 26 minutes is...
Let him live. Come on.
How long it takes. We have the feathers coming out. We have the spears and all that fun jazz as they're going in for this one. And they do pick up the kill. And as it is fun and games here, Teddy is still looking for kills under the fountain here. As there you go. He's even going to survive. As 26 and a half minutes, T1 dominate them in game number two as well. And Man, that is a refreshing look for T1 once again, back to back. Got to be feeling happy if you're a T1 fan.
When you draw Renekton in Italy, you set yourself for a problem, which is, are you good enough? Are you strong enough? Are you aggressive enough? Do you win lane? When the answer to that question is yes, it is just absolutely devastating, as we saw here. Nothing to be done here for DRX. It was a risk, surely, taken in draft, but when you see them pay it off like this, there is not a lot that you can do. Past that early game as DRX, you know, you just look back to it. I guess when we see them, they'll probably still all be smiling, because I really like the brushes, right? It was multiple Mission Impossibles. Unfortunately, unlike the movies, in this case, Mission Impossible was actually Mission Impossible. We know that they are incredibly strong, and yeah, that is a very different game, here coming out from Teddy, who this time got to play in a composition that actually, you know, wants to get close to him.
It's gonna be Kyria on Leona. Yeah, it's a fantastic roam play pulled off by Kyria.